Students, let's proceed to the next question. That is question number 13 of your back exercise. The question says, a hot plate of an electric oven connected to a 220 volt line has two resistance coils A and B, each of 24 ohm resistance, which may be used separately, in series or in parallel. What are the current in the three cases? It is a very simple numerical, students. You have been given that the hot plate of electric oven has two coils, right? And the resistance of each coil is 24 ohm. And we have to find the current which will be consumed by them if we use them separately or when we use them in series and then when we use them in parallel. So, first of all, we will find when we use them separately. When used separately, current will be I is equal to V by R. R is the resistance of each coil. V is 220 volt. It is given to us in the question. And R is 24. Solving this, we will get the value of current, that will be about 9.166 ampere. Now, when we connect them in series, total resistance will increase, that is RS is equal to R plus R is equal to 24 plus 24, that is 48 ohm. So again, we will find the value of I using Ohm's law. I is equal to V by RS. V is how much? 220. And your RS is 48. So since the resistance is doubled, the value of current will become half. It will come out to be about 4.58 ampere. Now, in parallel, one by RP is equal to one by R plus one by R, that is 1/24 plus 1/24. This becomes 1/12. Hence your RP is 12 ohm. Again, we will find the value of I using the formula V by R. So I is equal to V by RP. V is 220, and your RP is 12. The value of current will be about 18.3 bar ampere. So we have noticed that in series the resistance is doubled, so the value of current is reduced to half, and in parallel the resistance of the combination is reduced to half, therefore current is doubled. Right, students? Now read question number 14. Question number 14 says, compare the power used in the 2 ohm resistor in each of the following circuits. In question number 1, in part 1, he has given you two resistors. One is of 1 ohm and other is of 2 ohm. And both the resistors are connected in series with a 6 volt battery. And he wants you to calculate the power consumed. Students, we have two formula now. We can use the formula power is equal to V square by R. We can also use the formula power is equal to I square R. Right, students? One thing we should always remember, that in series current remains constant. So the current in the circuit, suppose the current I is flowing in the circuit, the same current will flow through 2 ohm resistor, because he wants you to calculate the power used in 2 ohm resistor. So if I find the current through the circuit, I can easily find the current through 2 ohm resistor, and I can find the power using the formula I square R. I am not using the formula V square by R, although V is given to me, but this V is the potential difference across the entire circuit. It is not the potential difference across R2, that is 2 ohm. So we cannot use the formula V square by R. If you want to use that formula, for that you have to calculate potential difference across 2 ohm first. Right, students? And in order to calculate current, we should know that equivalent resistance of the circuit, that is R1 plus R2, 1 plus 2 becomes 3 ohm. And the current is circuit I is equal to V by R, V is 6, R is 3. So 2 ampere current is flowing in the circuit. The same current will flow through 2 ohm resistor. So power is equal to I square R. 2 square is the current through 2 ohm resistor and resistance is 2. So it becomes 8 watt. In the second part, he has given you two resistors which are connected in parallel with a 4 volt battery. The resistance are 12 ohm and 2 ohm. Now in parallel we know that the current divides. That means the current in the circuit is not same as the current through 2 ohm resistor which we have used in this. Right? We cannot use that concept in this parallel combination. But in parallel we know that the potential difference across each resistor is equal to the potential difference applied in the circuit. तो जो 4 वोल्ट का पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस होगा वही पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस 2 ओम के अक्रॉस होगा. तो आई कैन डायरेक्टली यूज द फॉर्मूला पावर इज इक्वल टू वी स्क्वायर बाय आर. वी इज द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस अक्रॉस 2 ओम दैट इज 4 वोल्ट एंड आर इज द रेजिस्टेंस आर 2 दैट इज 2. दिस बिकम 16/2 इक्वल टू 8 वॉट. I hope you have understood why I have used different formulas in both the circuits. Right students, in series current remains constant, therefore I have used the formula I square R. Whereas in parallel, potential difference remains constant, therefore I have used the formula V square by R. Let's proceed to the next question. The question says, two lamps, one rated 100 watt at 220 volt, and the other 60 watt at 220 volt are connected in parallel to the electric main supply. What current is drawn from the line if the supply voltage is 220 volt? Students, in this question he has given you two bulbs, or I should say two lamps, which are connected in parallel with a 220 volt supply line. Power of first bulb is 100 watt and the second is 60 watt. He wants you to calculate the total current drawn from the line if the supply voltage is 220 volt. Kitna current line se draw hoga, matlab total pure circuit mein kitna current flow hoga. Parallel mein current divides as per resistance. So the total current is equal to the sum of current flowing through these two lamps. Let current through R1 be I1 and R2 be I2. If I'll find the value of I1, I2, I can calculate I, that is I is equal to I1 plus I2. And now how I'll find the value of I1, I2? We have been given power of each bulb. So we can find the current through each bulb by using the formula power is equal to VI. P1 is equal to VI1. Power is 100, V is 220, I1. So, the value of I1 becomes 10/22 or 5/11. Similarly, I can find the current through bulb 2 using the formula power is equal to VI. Potential difference is same. P2 is 60, V is 220. So this implies I2 is 60/220. 3/11. So total current I is equal to I1 plus I2, that is 5/11 plus 3/11 equal to 8/11 ampere. I hope you have understood the question, students.